have a patient that's an ACL reconstruction. ACL reconstructions, whether they're 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks out of surgery, you can work with them on this machine. The difference is though, as we all know as physical therapists, you have to range limit their extension so you don't stretch the graft. So with this machine, what we can do is whatever weight you choose or the patient chooses, he's gonna push out into the pad to engage the quad and then bring it up, say to this level. But if I wanna range limit him, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here and I can range limit him to whatever level I need. So therefore we're gonna protect the graft. So let's assume he's got a right ACL and now he's gonna work the quad, but he's not gonna stretch the graft. If he had a meniscus surgery, if he had patellofemoral surgery, if he had ACL, this is the range that you wanna work in the initial phases of rehabilitation. As he moves along into the 8 to 12 to 10 weeks to 16 weeks out of surgery, as we know, we can load that joint even more and we can open this up. Very simple to open it up. Again, you're gonna range limit and then you can bring it up even more. And then bring it back down slowly. The next patient population you wanna really focus on is total joints. So total joints, again, you see them 4, 5, 6 days out of surgery. Once you do see them, you wanna gain the strength back as soon as you can. I see patients and I put them on this machine 6 days out of surgery just to start getting some quad firing. So again, I'm gonna range limit, lightweight, and you wanna make sure that you're just getting the quad to fire. So say for example, we're assuming he's got a right total knee. So we're gonna lighten the weight. We're gonna range limit again by pulling out this knob, pulling it down, locking it in wherever we choose. And then single leg, we're gonna bring this up and then back down. So as we're doing that, we're gonna engage the quad, okay? For this patient population, lightweight, and as he's coming to therapy, you open him up to where he can gain more strength throughout the full range for the quad. Now, on the flip side, the nice thing about this machine, which is very unique to this machine and no other, is this joint axis will line up with the joint space. For flexion, this also will do that by one switch of a knob. So we're gonna demonstrate that and show how we do that. Okay, so again, we're gonna reverse the process. This will be pushed up. This will move over. Okay, easy exit. And then what we do is we switch this lever here and we just pull it up and knock it down. And what that does is that's gonna line up the axis if we're gonna work hamstrings. So again, same system. Now the difference here is we need to change the angle for hamstrings, whether your patient population is for meniscus tear, you have an ACL, total joint, even hip replacement. The way you do that is this knob here, if you pull it up, you can bring their legs, say, up to here. Now, with a total knee, one of the big key features with a total joint, as we all know, as therapists, is you have to gain extension. The hamstring is most efficient at 33 degrees. So if the patient starts here and they pull down to about here, that's about 33 degrees. But again, they're not gonna know that. So with this range limiting device in the back, you can go ahead and you can now pull down. And then you can range limit and bring it back up. And let me go here and then do it again. And back up. But I want more extension. So I'm gonna bring this up here and now do it. Then back down. So what I'm doing is I'm gaining small range of motion for the hamstring. And again, I can change that very easily as we're going along. Okay, now go. There we go. So you have an ACL that is 4 weeks out of surgery, 6 weeks out of surgery. You need to work their hamstrings because that protects the ACL graft. In this position, pulling down from A to B, they will work the hamstring most efficiently, but they won't put pressure on the graft. And this machine, again, like I said before, it's gonna line up the axis correctly. It's easy entrance, it's ease of comfort, and it's very easy to adjust these levers, and patients can help you as well because they get used to where they're supposed to be and they know what to do, and it's very easy to teach them how to do all these things. But I encourage you to look into this type of device because if you If you get this device, you could work a whole bunch of patient populations. You can have them gain strength, range of motion, endurance, and function.